We're asked to use the symbols less than, equal to, or greater than to compare the fractions and make a true statement. Remember, for a fraction, the denominator indicates how many parts in the whole. The numerator indicates how many parts are being considered. So the fraction 1/4 means we're considering one part, or it takes 4 parts to make a whole, and the fraction 1/2 means we're considering one part, or it takes 2 parts to make the whole, which means 1/4 is less than 1/2. Next, we're comparing 3/6 to itself, and therefore 3/6 is equal to 3/6. Next, we have 3/7 compared to 3/2. 3/7 means we're considering 3 parts, where it takes 7 parts to make the whole, and 3/2 means we're considering 3 parts, where it takes 2 parts to make the whole. So for both fractions, we're considering the same number of parts, but for 3/7, the parts are smaller, and therefore 3/7 is less than 3/2. Next, we have 2/5 compared to 4/5. 2/5 means we're considering 2 parts, where it takes 5 parts to make a whole, and 4/5 means we're considering 4 parts, where again it takes 5 parts to make a whole. So for these two fractions, the parts are the same size, but because for 2/5, we're considering less parts, 2/5 is less than 4/5. Next, we have 5/7 compared to 5/9. 5/7 means we're considering 5 parts, where it takes 7 parts to make a whole, and for 5/9, we're also considering 5 parts, but now it takes 9 parts to make a whole. So because for 5/7, the parts are larger, 5/7 is greater than 5/9. And for the last problem, we're comparing 4/8 to 1/2. 4/8 means we're considering 4 parts, where it takes 8 parts to make a whole. Because we're considering half the parts that make a whole, 4/8 equals 1/2. I hope you found this helpful.